Hyakkimaru, move with the left analog stick, not with the directional button. Good, well done, Hyakkimaru. Move with the left analog stick while holding down the L1 button. This will allow you to strafe from side to side. Use it to avoid exposing your back to your enemy. Press the L1 button to center the camera in the direction you are facing. Jump with the X. Yes, very good, Hyakkimaru. Now try pressing the X button one more time while in mid-jump. Now try pressing the X button one more time while in mid-jump. Now try pressing the X button one more time while in mid-jump. Well done! That was an excellent double jump. Now for back. The square button does a light attack and the trap. You're a quick learner. Now, I will show you a very special technique. Press and hold the triangle button. When your sword flashes, let go of the triangle button. Attack the enemy using that technique. Then press the buttons as they appear on the screen. Once again, Hyakkimaru, press and hold the triangle. When your sword flashes, let go of the triangle button. Attack the enemy using that technique. Press and hold the triangle button. When your sword flashes, let go of the triangle button. Attack the enemy using that technique. Then press the buttons as they appear on the screen. Once the enemy's health has been depleted, press the triangle button. Concentrate. Press and hold the triangle button. When your sword flashes, let go of the triangle button. Attack the enemy using that technique. Press and hold the triangle button. Practice is perfect, Hyakkimaru. Practice as often as you can. Try to get as many slashes as you can. You may be rewarded. Look, your attacks have caused your spirit gauge to fill up. See the blue gauge blinking in the upper left corner. Now, press the square button and the triangle button simultaneously. Excellent! You have successfully performed a spirit attack. You will be able to learn more spirit attacks by finding spirit scrolls. Press the L2 button to change weapons. See how the weapon in your hand changed? Press the L2 button to change weapons. See how the weapon in your hand changed? Try attacking with that sword. Excellent swordsmanship. There are many other kinds of swords. Be sure to try each one at least once. Finally, I will explain how to use the weapons I have built into your body. First, your right arm. While using your sword arm, press the R1 button. Impressive, isn't it? I call it the repeater arm cannon. Your sword arm strong. It is very effective, but there is limited ammo, so use it wisely. Now your left leg. Press and hold the R2 button. Once you select your target, now your left leg. Press and hold the R2 button. Once you select your target using the cursor, press the triangle button. Quite powerful. Hey, Akimaru. I call it the guided leg cannon. It is very powerful. Special ammo. Use it sparingly. Oh, I almost forgot. Those swords in your arms? As you defeat demons with them, the swords will increase in level. Be sure to use them often, Hyakkimaru, for they will serve you well. Hyakkimaru, your journey begins here. Do your will. Be strong. Defeat the 48 fiends and return here alive. I await you, Hyakkimaru.
Thank you. Thank you. demons.
Thank you.
Found one. These fiends live off the sorrow and despair of humans. I'm here to take back my body.
Thank you.
My voice. It's my own voice. I got my voice back.
The world was ravaged by unending war. The people cried to the heavens, their hearts full of despair. Unbeknownst to them, the world was at the mercy of a group of vile demons known as fiends. One day, a terrible omen appeared in the sky. When morning came, not one, but two suns rose in the east. However, while one sun shined more brightly than ever, the other gave off a dull, black light, as if it were but a shadow of the real sun. It seemed as though the gods of the heavens could no longer bear to witness the troubled times on earth, and parted ways with the gods of darkness. The gods of darkness, the fiends, looked upon this omen with fear. To them, the appearance of two suns foretold the birth of a human that would have the power to end their dark rule. However, the fiends could not destroy this child of light themselves. They discovered, however, they could corrupt the child's birth parents. The fiends approached Kagemitsu Daigo, a local samurai and the future father of the Child of Light, and enticed him with promises of power. One night, in his dreams, Kagemitsu Daigo saw a vision. In this vision, he was told that he would be given the power to bring order to this chaotic world. Daigo, thinking that he had received a vision from the heavens, gathered all his courage and ventured to the temple called the Gates of Hell. Alone. As Daigo stood there, surrounded by the possessed statues of the 48 fiends, he was told that the price of his power would be his firstborn child. The sudden demand threw Daigo into a panic. Heightened by the echoing laughter of the fiends, his mind began to twist, and Daigo's reason and judgment failed him at last. He signed the contract. A few days later, Daigo's child was born. This was much to the surprise of Daigo himself. As he had expected, the fiends would lay claim to his child. Daigo dared to allow himself to feel a moment of joy and relief, but that moment proved to be short-lived. Shadows gathered over the newborn, wrapping themselves around its tiny body. A voice sounded from within the shadows. "The body of your son now belongs to the 48 fiends. As promised, you shall be granted the power to bring order to this pitiful world. You shall never know defeat in battle from this day forth. Your path to victory shall be littered with the corpses of those who defy you." 48 parts of the infant's body had been stolen by the fiends. Seeing what happened to his son, Daigo let out a blood-curdling scream in anguish. Suddenly, Daigo sprang into action. He snatched up the infant in his arms, jumped atop his trusty steed, Midoro. His wife desperately tried to stop him, but Daigo shrugged her off and made his way toward the river.
Stay back. Killed all the demons. My arm? It's fake. Let's not go telling everyone about this, okay? Why are you following me?
That sword in your arm! I bet it was forged by a master swordsmith.
I don't know. Maybe it was. It works good enough for me.
I thought so. You mind if I take it?
Take it? You? Don't make me laugh.
I am the world-famous thief, Dororo. Come rain or shine, once I set my eyes on a treasure, it's mine.
I don't think you get it. This thing is attached to my arm. It's a part of me.
You can't get rid of me that easily. I will get that sword.
Are you stupid? Staying near me is certain death. You saw them, didn't you? I'm haunted by ghosts and demons.
Well, the world-famous thief is afraid of nothing.
Thief or not, don't follow me. can see. I can see through my left eye. Dororo. You're Dororo. Your voice is a little annoying, but you're a cuter kid than I thought.
Hey, is that your eye?
Go ahead, pick it up.
It's a fake eye!
You scared? I don't blame you. When I was a baby, I was found floating in the river in a barrel.
Having returned from his studies in China, the physician Zhukai had been gathering herbs near the river. To his surprise, he came upon a barrel floating by, carrying in it a tiny infant. Perhaps it was his medical training that urged him to save the child, or perhaps it was human instinct. But Zhukai did not hesitate but for a second before he rescued the child from the barrel. Yet upon examining the child, he was at a loss for words, for he did not know any medicines that could help this cursed infant. However, as Zhukai fed the child, he watched the infant sip at its porridge. He felt its burning desire to live and decided to raise the child as his own. One day, a strange voice buzzed in Zhukai's ear. "Feed me. Feed me," the voice pleaded. He looked around in search of the source of the voice. The infant was staring straight at him with its empty eyes. "Could it be," he said aloud, "were you the one speaking to me?" "Yes," the voice echoed in his mind. Zhukai realized that the child could speak directly to his mind. From that day forward, Zhukai communicated with the child telepathically and taught him everything he needed to know about living in this cruel world. When the child turned 3, Zhukai made a decision. He decided to operate on the child. He would use all his medical knowledge to give the child everything he was missing. Arms, legs, eyes, nose, ears, everything that the child lacked. He began the operation. After many, many hours, a miracle happened. At the end of the surgery, when the anesthetics had worn off, the child opened his eyes. And for the first time, the child had a complete body, and he had a name, Hyakkimaru. Within a month after the surgery, Hyakkimaru began to learn to use his new body. He sat up, moved his legs, and took his first steps. He stumbled many times, but every time he picked himself back up and tried again. The pain was nearly unbearable, and every day he worked himself to the point of nearly collapsing. Soon Hyakkimaru was able to run about as free as any child. When Hyakkimaru turned 6, Zhukai had been watching him run and play like any child would. Despite the fact that he could not see, he knew at that moment that with such wondrous gifts, a strange and fantastic destiny would surely be awaiting Hyakkimaru. As Hyakkimaru grew older, strange things began to occur. Demons began to appear all around them, watching their every move. When Hyakkimaru turned 18, he visited a local temple. While praying, a voice spoke to him from the heavens. "The 48 fiends have each taken a part of your body, young Hyakkimaru. You must slay these fiends and retrieve what is rightfully yours. However, the fiends have also created a human out of your body parts. Slay the fiends or their human creation and you shall become whole once again. Yakimaru, sensing the seriousness of the situation, sat down to speak with Jukai. Yakimaru knew that the fiends were after him. He knew it was because of his special powers that the demons wanted him dead. Even though he had artificial limbs and could not see nor hear, he could see things with some sort of innate sixth sense. He knew that the fiends considered him a threat and would do anything to get rid of him. Yakimaru decided that he must seek out the fiends and destroy them. To help him accomplish this, Jukai decided to perform one final operation on Yakimaru. He fitted Yakimaru's body with various powerful weapons. As Yakimaru prepared to set off on his quest, Jukai warned Yakimaru of the dangers he was sure to face. He explained that fiends lived off of human suffering and grief. He told Yakimaru that if he encountered any peoples burdened with inexplicable pain or suffering, chances are he would find a fiend nearby.
If it's free, I'll take it.
Bamboo thicket. Just ahead. So shiny.
Hey, Yaki. Did you see that creep last night?
Yeah, you looked so scared, I thought you'd start crying.
You'd think I was scared of that freak? If I gave him a nasty look, he'd have run away crying. He was probably an amateur thief. He's probably headed for that village over there. We should go check it out.
Thank you. girl!
Right on it, Hiaki!
Dororo!
Gotcha! Gotcha.
Dororo!
Gotcha.
Dororo!
Gotcha. Gotcha.
Dororo.
Gotcha.
Dororo!
Right on it, Hiaki!
Dororo!
Right on it, Hiaki!
Dororo!
Gotcha!
Dororo!
Gotcha! something's not right. Something's not right. Something's not right.
Gotcha.
right on it, Hyaki.
Dororo!
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Yeah!
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 But seriously, what kind of thief goes around ringing a bell like that?
Yeah, you've got a good point.
You say you saw a man ringing a bell?
You saw the troll?
These two saw the troll!
Who the heck is the troll?
Men, quickly! We must bring them to Mistress Yudai!
Yeah!
What are you doing? We haven't done anything!
I have been told that you two have met the troll. Quite unlucky for you. However, I cannot undo your bonds just yet.
What's going on? Why can't you let us go?
The troll is, of course, not human. It is a monster, an evil spirit. He would have spoken to one of you. To which of you did he speak? What did he say to you? I must know what he said.
I didn't hear anything.
How about you, sir?
Don't know.
That is impossible. If you do not answer my question, I cannot release your bonds. Now tell me the truth. There is nothing to be gained by lying to me.
Said I don't know.
Yaki!
You leave me no choice. I shall put you in the well room like all the others.
Come on, Yaki! What did the troll say to you? You can tell me!
Quiet! Something's coming from the well. This just keeps getting better and better. Ha!
Dororo!
Gotcha!
Jackie!
heck was that?
A demon. But I've never encountered one so powerful before. It might be a demon that stole one of my body parts. I cut it pretty deep. I need to go into the well to see if it's dead.
Hey! Hang on just a second! Leave it to me! This is what I do best! Bones! Lots of them! They were probably sent here to get eaten too!
Yudai. That damn woman meant to kill us. She never expected us to get out of this place alive. I wonder how many people she has tied up here and fed to that demon. But why is she so intent on killing anyone who saw the troll? There must be some sort of connection between Yudai and the troll. We should check the bamboo thicket that the troll mentioned.
Tunnel! And there's blood leading to it!
Get back up here! That probably leads to where the demon lives.
I can feel a breeze. This passage probably leads somewhere outside. I'm gonna go check it out real quick.
Don't be stupid! Get back here, Dororo!
Thank you. Someone's there!
Get him!
Damn it! Let me go!
Tie him up and bring him to the East Town Square!
Thank you. Yeah!